After years of planning and the release of 5 separate feature films, Marvel now had the opportunity and the pressure to go along with it to deliver the epic film that movie audiences have been longing for.
Marvel Studios is going to take all of their top superheroes and they're going to put them all together in the Avengers. That's the most ambitious movie I've ever seen.
We have a new challenge with the Avengers that we hadn't had before. Not only do we have comic books, we now have movies that people fall in love with. We got to look back at Iron Man 1, we got to look at Iron Man 2, we got to look at Hulk, we got to look at Thor, we got to look at Captain America, and let's see what we've established, how our own filmmaking can inform the storytelling that we're going to do on this film. So it makes for a unique challenge when putting Avengers together, because it's really, how do we pay off this cinematic universe that we've established? How do we give fans of the movies what they want while still honoring fans of the comics and giving them what they want as well?
With a film as massive as The Avengers, Marvel knew they had to find the right director. Joss Whedon, who had created such cult hits as Buffy the Vampire Slayer and Firefly, had the perfect DNA for the job.
What Joss is better at than almost anyone I've ever worked with, Joss is the first pure writer-director that we've had on one of our Marvel Studios films, is looking at the big picture, is looking at setting, you know, and sowing seeds that are gonna grow at a certain point, set up some payoffs. He constantly sees the big picture.
He wrote the script. Reading that first draft, I was blown away.
With Joss, we have a guy who is capable of a real-world tone and of incredible humor. So as a result, you get a script that works from a tone level and has terrific humor in it. And that's really fun because Joss is a guy who wrote the stuff, he believes in it, and he can really stand there and point to it and say, this is what my intention was. My intention was to bring the humor, to keep the real-world tone, and to bring it all together. And I think the actors can respond to that and go, I'm on board.
That happens. You look around, and then, you know what, I will give you a position to look up. See where the trapeze is?
Yes.
Look up, and that'll take you. That's the thunder guy.
We're talking about a more complex piece of machinery here, trying to interface these characters to where they all make sense, all have arcs, and nobody has to do too much heavy lifting, though everybody gets their day in the sun.
What a massive challenge. Impossible, really, in so many ways, to really assemble all these characters that normally are number one to carry that movie.
The only thing I really had to worry about was making these people matter to the audience. The only way you can approach anything is through the relationship to the character. Do the people care?
We're casting personas that have already been proven to work when you put them all together. Tony Stark, Hulk, Thor, Cap, they're such different personalities, right? So you cast the best person for those personalities, you do your job right, when you put them together, it's going to be as fun as it is in the comics.
For movie audiences, most of the Avengers will look familiar, having met the characters in previous Marvel movies. However, one member of the team may not be as recognizable.
The idea of using Hawkeye came from Marvel, who had said they wanted Hawkeye on the team because he was a fan favorite.
Hawkeye swept into the Marvel Universe in 1964 with an appearance in the comic Tales of Suspense. The character, also known as Clint Barton, was first introduced as a reluctant villain. In just over a year, though, Hawkeye would seek redemption and fight crime alongside the rest of the Avengers. Filmmakers cast Jeremy Renner in the role, making his first appearance in a cameo in Thor.
I need eyes up high.
You want me to slow him down, sir? Or are you sending in more guys for him to beat up?
We have a guy who is a master assassin. He's very, very skilled. He's probably off his rocker a little bit. He's a little bit nuts, he's a little bit crazy, but he's good at his job.
But he's fascinating. I mean, he's preternatural with the bow and arrow. He can just do anything.
He's a lone wolf kind of guy anyway. Not really a team player. I think he kind of does his own thing, you know?
Jeremy, as an actor, I think, brings a wry, brooding, sarcastic, devil-may-care attitude to the character, and that's just part of his personality coming through. And that's what makes the casting so inspired, is that Jeremy has that kind of rogue quality, and that's what makes him so much fun to watch.
You think you can hold him off?
Captain, be my genuine pleasure.
In addition to new characters, the filmmakers decided to give the Hulk a makeover, casting actor Mark Ruffalo in the iconic role.
I had always felt that Mark was the guy to play Bruce Banner because there's something immensely introspective and affable about the guy.
It's good to meet you, Dr. Banner.
Your work on anti-electron collisions is unparalleled, and I'm a huge fan of the way you lose control and turn into an enormous green rage monster.
Thanks.
This idea of bringing like this darker, a different kind of more humanistic moving Hulk was really exciting and compelling.
Filmmakers also used cutting-edge technology that gave Ruffalo the chance to leave his imprint on the character.
Before, they've always been a CGI creature that very much was a CGI creature, but now with the motion capture technology that we have, you know, we're building every expression and movement that the Hulk does off of Mark.
It's a real creature, you know? It's very human. There's a sense of humor there. There's an ability to communicate. And he's dangerous, incredibly dangerous. He's a wild animal.
And the Hulk wasn't the only hero getting a new look.
We weren't looking to do like X-Men, solidifying them through certain design choices to feel as a unified team. They're not a unified team for much of the film. That's kind of the point of the Avengers. You know, we did do things like decide, you know what, when Thor's on the helicarrier and when he's standing next to people that are relatively in normal costumes, we're gonna take off his cape, we're gonna take off his sleeves, we're gonna take off his outer armor point. So he's still very much this Asgardian god standing amongst them, but isn't, you know, standing over them like a statue.
No one told me it wasn't a fancy dress. This is embarrassing.
When I first met Joss about the film, he goes, there's a couple of things I want to change. I want to make the hammer big, just like 10, 15%. So the hammer's bigger. It's a slightly different design. I think it looks prettier. Pretty is the wrong word. It looks, there's a bit of class to it, you know? It's not quite as rugged as the other one.
These guys come from legend. They're basically gods.
There's only one god, man. And I'm pretty sure he doesn't dress like that.
Bringing Captain America into the modern day, he's gonna have a new suit, a new outfit that S.H.I.E.L.D. has designed for him. Clearly, S.H.I.E.L.D. loved this notion of having Captain America back, and they wanted a big, bright red, white, and blue costume to go along with it.
The people in this room, which one is A, wearing a spangly outfit, and B, not of use?
It's a different uniform. It obviously is a bit more sleek. The first uniform had to look not only period, but somewhat utilitarian. It's wartime, so it has to look like it would function on a battlefield. This one just looks a little bit more modern and slick, and it's, on a personal level, it's incredibly more mobile. It's, you know, it's much nicer to get in and out of.
And Iron Man, of course, working on his suits, that color scheme is pretty well defined by now. His suit always evolves. He's always upgrading it. He's always coming up with new ideas and new gadgets for it. And everybody knows what color Hulk is. So we're not messing with that formula. We're taking the formula which has worked for so long in one medium and trying to do as good a job as possible bringing up to that big silver screen.
The thing about the Avengers is it's a story of people who really have no business being in the same movie. Sort of the glory of the Avengers is the dissonance you get between the Hulk and Thor and Captain America and Iron Man and Black Widow and Hawkeye. These guys are gonna come up against each other. They're not gonna get along. And when you don't get along with the Hulk, you don't usually talk it out.
It's dangerous.
For Joss Whedon, capturing the Avengers' dysfunctional dynamic on film was no easy task.
This is the day that I have dreaded the most since I wrote the script. I have all of the principal characters except for Jeremy Renner. I have 1 through 6 on the call sheet, all in the same room, all talking over each other. Writing the scene was horrifically difficult, but more importantly, shooting it seems next to impossible, except that everybody is so dialed in. They're doing so well that nobody's noticed that I have no idea where to put the camera or what's actually what's going on.
Excuse me, did we come to your planet and blow stuff up?
Good, no, that's good.
It's not like the Avengers come together and it's like a big party and we all love each other.
You're not going alone.
You gonna stop me?
Put on the suit, let's find out.
I'm not afraid to hit an old man. Put on the suit.
It's like everybody's fighting and hating and making fun of each other.
Man, I feel like there'd be like a little improv on the ground there, like I put on like an animal mask and we start really seeing how we felt about each other. Then we suit up.
It's like the most dysfunctional family you'd ever meet. They come into this group and think, we don't fit together, you know?
You have all of these different egos and personalities trying to come together to serve something greater than ourselves.
Now, they're all incredibly powerful, but because of their abilities and their power, they're very alone as well.
You speak of control, yet you court chaos.
This is MO, isn't it? I mean, what are we, a team? No. We're a chemical mixture that makes chaos. We're a time bomb.
For the Avengers to come together, you need a threat that is very, very big. And you need a threat that is incredibly destructive. And you need to cause mayhem that makes the audience go, how are they ever going to stop that?
Today we blew up the whole world. I don't remember writing anything quite as big as what we just shot. I don't think anybody's left alive, including the Avengers, so that might turn out to be a problem later on.
We blew up 15 cars, we had 21 explosions, 30 to 40 stunt people, 350 extras. I mean, if that doesn't get your blood going, then nothing will.
Working on believing.
I think what makes this film stand out is the grounded nature with which Joss has infused this film. In my mind, a throwback to what people loved in Iron Man, the original, it's everything that Joss loves about sci-fi, which is being able to escape in this otherworldly reality, but have it still be heartfelt and sincere.
This is Loki. This is monsters and magic and nothing we were ever trained for.
There is a lot of depth to this movie. But it's such a historic story of, like, coming together and, like, fighting the bad guy.
What are you asking me to do?
I'm asking, what are you prepared to do?
It looks awesome. Now, yes, superheroes flying through buildings and risk factor goes up. So to see the Avengers battling it out in the streets of New York is pretty epic.
The power surrounding the cube is impenetrable.
Thor's right. We got to deal with these guys.
How do we do this?
As a team.
Marvel's The Avengers premiered on April 11th, 2012. An intense journey was about to pay off.
The movie's finished. People are about to see the movie. What started as Stan Lee, you know, 50 years ago, 45 years ago, coming up with this idea to put all the heroes in one story, and what continued about 6 or 7 years ago with three or four of us in a room saying, wouldn't it be cool if? And now here it is. It's pretty amazing.
I remember when we were all huddled around at an Italian dinner table waiting for the numbers to come in on the first Iron Man. And my take back in the day with John and with Kevin and Jeremy and everybody was always, you know, well, let's see how far we can go with that. And then we had a bunch of fun doing the second one. And this time I feel like all three of the avenues that have been explored so far with Cap, Thor, and Tony have all worked in and of themselves separately. So that's more than enough to imagine that putting us together should be really exciting.
Well, the real diehard fans, you know, and like the Comic-Con folk and all that, of which I'm kind of one, honorary one, have been wondering and imagining if something like the Avengers would ever happen. So, you know, they get their wish this year.
That is when it all makes it worthwhile. All that hard work, when you hear the laughter and the clapping or the wow or the sadness, you feel it. You can actually feel it in theater. And that for me is everything.
If we can create that for any generation or any kid when they go see that movie and you go, wow, that was cool.
We really put a lot into this. We work really hard to give the audience the best experience possible. It's truly a remarkable feeling.
The idea that these 6 years have all paid off and being here tonight on Hollywood Boulevard at the El Capitan with the entire cast of the Avengers, and we're finally making the movie and we're finally getting to show it to the world, the most exciting thing in the world.
So it's been going on for 6 years now, obviously. We've got Iron Man, Iron Man 2, Thor, Captain America. These are all chapters in a book, in a kind of giant epic novel, pop culture mythology that's very American, very unusual. And this is where it all pays off.
We're all just stewards of these characters, which is amazing. I wouldn't want to be doing anything else. This is the culmination of many, many years of work for us at Marvel Studios. But who knows what will happen, you know, as we go off into the future.
history.
Nice.
There we go.